Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Wednesday of the 15th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. As for me, in justice I shall behold your face. I shall be filled with a vision of your glory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and to strive after all that does it honor. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the priest of Midian. Leading the flock across the desert, he came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in fire flaming out of a bush. As he looked on, he was surprised to see that the bush, though on fire, was not consumed. So Moses decided, I must go over to look at this remarkable sight and see why the bush is not burned. When the Lord saw him coming over to look at it more closely, God called out to him from the bush, Moses, Moses. He answered, Here I am. God said, Come no nearer. Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground. I am the God of your father, he continued, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. The cry of the children of Israel has reached me, and I have truly noted that the Egyptians are oppressing them. Come now, I will send you to Pharaoh to lead my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt. But Moses said to God, Who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and lead the children of Israel out of Egypt? He answered, I will be with you, and this shall be your proof that it is I who have sent you. When you bring my people out of Egypt, you will worship God on this very mountain. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is kind and merciful.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
The Lord secures justice and the rights of all the oppressed. He has made known his ways to Moses and his deeds to the children of Israel.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus exclaimed, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will, All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alam niyo, itong ebanghelyo natin ngayong araw tsaka bukas, no? Interesante siya kasi para siyang naiipit sa mga parts ng ebanghelyo ni San Mateo na parang medyo maano, no? Yung kagaya nga nung Lunes at kahapon, di ba medyo ano, medyo malakas, di ba? Medyo matindi yung sinasabi ng Panginoon, ano, sa ebanghelyo nung Lunes at Martes, no? At bukas at ngayon magbabasahin natin yung kumbaga ano naman to, malambot, ano, yung and very consoling yung sinasabi ng Panginoon. Tapos magsisimula ulit, ano, sa darating na Biyernes, ano ulit, medyo ang Panginoon meron na naman siyang, sabi nga natin, maanghang na salita laban sa religious authorities, no? So it's interesting that these two very, very, ano, very gentle and very compassionate gospels, today and tomorrow, are really, in a sense, sandwich, no? Between parts of the Gospel of Matthew that criticize the religious authorities of his time, no? And also the people who are, in a sense, did not listen to his word and did not undergo conversion. We saw that yesterday, no? And now let me just reflect on the gospel for today, because I think this one is a very beautiful gospel and very good to pray with, no? Number one, the invitation of the Lord is for us to become childlike again in our faith, to have a childlike confidence and trust in God, no? As our Father. And I think, you know, as we go through very difficult times in this pandemic, as we go through a very, you know, almost ano, a very turbulent world, not just in our country, but all over the world, I think it is good to enter that relationship with God as Father and we as children of the Father. And not just enter that relationship, but again to enter it in a very childlike manner. That the Lord Himself said, diba, that you have revealed this to the childlike. And let us just reflect, no, on the qualities of a child, no? Number one, a child doesn't have too many biases yet, no? Siguro yung una natin dapat pagnilayan na ang mga bata, di ba, ano yan eh, bilang na bilang mo yung bias. And kaya siguro sinasabi ng Panginoon, paano ba tayo babalik sa pagiging childlike? Ay siguro we need to be aware of biases, yung ating mga bias sa buhay. At siguro wag nating hayaang kontrolahin tayo ng ating biases. That's what it means, I think, to be childlike. Ano? It's to be aware of our biases. And to bracket, no, as they would say in philosophy, to bracket these biases, no. Siguro yung unang puntong yon, alamin natin kung ano yung mga reaksyon natin sa mga bagay-bagay, di ba? Kasi nagre-react tayo hindi kumisan hindi nakaugat sa katotohanan o sa masasabi natin fact, no. Pero nakaugat to sa ating biases. So we need to be childlike to be able to identify our biases and to be able to set them aside in trying to view what is God trying to tell us. No? That first point. No? And then the second point that I invite you to reflect on is that what is the other quality of a child? No? Not only does it have very little biases, but a child is very trusting. Very, very trusting. And siguro napapanahon din na pag-isipan natin, ano ba ang ating pananaw sa buhay? Tayo ba'y nagtitiwala sa buhay? Tayo ba'y nagtitiwala sa mga tao in general and above all, nagtitiwala sa Diyos, di ba? Tandaan niyo yung aking binanggit na sa mga ebanghelyo ko nung mga nakaraan, yung galing kay Father Hans Kung, di ba? Na tatlong bagay ang importante sa pagkakaroon ng makahulugang buhay, no? Spiritual elements of life, no? Sabi nga niya, number one is trust. Foundational ang trust. And then joy and then meaning. So here the Lord says, no, that to be childlike, again, no, is to trust, to have a stance of trust towards life. Pagtitiwala sa buhay, pagtitiwala sa kapwa, at pagtitiwala sa Diyos. And perhaps it's good to ask ourselves, nagtitiwala ba ako? Yung bang aking general attitude towards life? Do I have a general attitude of trusting towards life, other people, and God. The second point to reflect on. The third point that I invite you to reflect on in today's gospel is that, veering away now from being childlike, the third point is what the Lord said, no? That no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal Him. I think mahalagang ating maunawaan na ang pagbubunyag ng Diyos sa atin ay kaysa pamamagitan ni Kristo. That the fullness of God's revelation is through Christ, is through the Son. And more so, the fullness of that revelation is in the mystery of the cross and resurrection. Mahalaga yon na nakasentro ang ating buhay sa Panginoon, nakasentro ang ating pananampalataya in the revelation of Christ, the fullness of God's revelation. And I think it's also good to understand what is the peripheral elements. What is the inessentials? Kasi marami na hong nadagdag dyan, eh, di ba? Through the years, ano? Through, and remember, the church is constantly renewing itself, di ba? In fact, no, when we are in theology, we're constantly told that the church, in our ecclesiology class, it is the holy, sinful church that is always in need of reform, in need of renewal, no? And I think the renewal is towards always making Christ more and more the center of our life, our faith, our community, our mission. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God chose to reveal the mysteries of His kingdom not to the wise and the learned, but to the childlike. May we have the humility and the trust of the children, of the childlike, to experience God's graciousness in our lives. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
In a world looking for wisdom and powerful signs, may we cling to the saving cross of Christ, which is the power and the wisdom of God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the proud and the mighty remember that God resists the proud and raises up the humble, and will bring down the mighty from their throne. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we draw peace and happiness in the laughter of children, in the smile of simple folks, in the patience of parents, and in the wisdom of the elderly. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And together with the childlike trust in God, let us now pray our prayer for the 2022 elections. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa aming halalan 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Hesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagabaglingkod na unahin ang higit na kabubuti para sa higit na nakararami, lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina, higit sa anumang interes na pansarili o para sa grupo. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maghahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at pagkahabag. Banal na Espiritu, tanglawan ng aming mga isip at puso, ng aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangangailangan ng aming kapwa Pilipino, at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakayahang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ng tama ang mga pinuno na tunay na mumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung ano ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, Ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa oras na ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Imakulada Concepcion, Patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate His death. With living faith we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember, too, our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death, and to restore our hope and faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in serving and healing the victims of the virus. Protect them and grant them your inspiration to sustain them in body, mind, heart, and spirit. And for those who fell ill and passed on, reward them with eternal life with you and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe too and grant them your guidance. Most especially our leaders, to selflessly work for the common good and find meaning in their service. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their suffering be their participation in the suffering of your Son that redeemed us. For all who are infected, heal them and grant them full recovery. Continue to guide our experts tasked to find effective vaccines and cures for this virus. Use them as instruments in your healing hands. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you and have a good day.
Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Magpapatupad ang Caritas Pilipinas ng dalawang Alekapa programs simula ngayong last quarter ng taong 2021. Una ay scholarship assistance para sa ating mga kabataang academically low performers, mga areas na identified natin mula sa Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Tutulungan po natin sila. 500 students ang ating budget na matutulungan. Pangalawa, feeding program. Meron pong mga identified areas na mataas ang percentages ng hunger. Tutulungan din po natin sila at ang estimated budget po natin ay para sa mga 6,000 na mga kabataan. Samahan niyo po kami. Tulungan niyo po ang Alekapa program ng Caritas Pilipinas. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko. Pagpalain po tayong lahat ng puong may kapalan.